in 1894, it was the founding of MassBiologics, and it was at the dawn of our understanding of how you could prevent and treat certain infections. And the problem of the time was diphtheria. Every week, the forerunner of the New England Journal of Medicine would publish the cases of diphtheria, mostly in children, and what towns they occurred in, and then they would publish shortly thereafter that there were this many fatalities from diphtheria. There's no drug companies around. The responsibility for protecting the citizens from these public health menaces fell to the Commonwealth, to the state. And it's in that setting that MassBiologics was founded. And then there was a major discovery in Europe that if you took a little bit of serum that made an animal able to survive a challenge of diphtheria and the toxin, and you transferred that to another animal, that you could actually treat them.
The impact of having an anti-serum for diphtheria was enormous, because up until then you couldn't do anything about the complications of the disease, and having a way to treat it before there were any antibiotics was a major advance.
That sparked this whole era of using so-called immune serum, largely from horses, to treat a whole variety of infectious diseases, botulism, tetanus, and diphtheria. Shortly after it was made available, you could see gradually the dramatic reduction in both the incidence of cases as well as the fatalities from them. Fast forward to the 40s, and here MassBiologics does what it does best, and that is addressing the public health need of the time. There was a huge need for human serum albumin in the 40s, largely to protect or to treat soldiers who would be wounded on the battlefield. And through the work of Cohn, who developed this cone fractionation that was all prototyped here at MassBiologics in the late 30s and 40s, MassBiologics became a major source of human proteins, both to treat infectious diseases as well as replacement therapy for wounded soldiers on the battlefield. At the same time, we were still making vaccines, and we recently received a wonderful thank you note from a gentleman whose father's life was saved from tetanus.
My father, he grew up in Shrewsbury. He was skating on Jordan Pond. He was 16 years old, catching a blade on his foot, and they took him to the doctor. They sewed him up, and it got infected, and that's how he got sick. Would have probably died if he had not had the tetanus shot, because he was one of the first people to get that. Somebody drove the serum in from Boston. He was dying, and they gave him the serum, and he had a high fever, and within a couple of days he regained his health, and within a week he was out of the hospital. And if it wasn't for the tetanus serum, my father probably would not have survived that accident. Thank you very much. I appreciate that from the bottom of my heart, and from my dad's as well.
It bursts with pride, quite honestly. You know, I mean, everybody, I think, in the world seeks to make a difference.
As needs changed, we had a mechanism within the public sector to respond to those changes and respond to those challenges. The biologic laboratories was a way of translating the science to public health. How do you take current science and use it in a way that translates into a benefit?
The secret to MassBiologics' sustainability is that it needs to stay focused on the problems of the day and either adapt to or innovate the technology that supports addressing those problems. In India, there are approximately 10,000 deaths every year from rabies. We invented a monoclonal antibody. We then transferred that technology to an Indian organization, the Serum Institute of India, and they then brought it forward commercially. And we are about to see a dawning there of a dramatic reduction in the number of deaths. We've been able to build an organization that can address problems that doesn't first ask the question, will this be profitable? We ask the question, where can we make the biggest impact? Where's the most important medical need? MassBiologics has taken advantage of the great wealth of scientific expertise at our medical school. And in those areas where we've innovated, especially in the area of RNA and oligonucleotides, as well as on gene therapeutics, we've adapted and innovated in those areas to be able to support those activities and bring medicines forward that can actually do that.
RNA-based therapeutics, oligonucleotide-based therapeutics, is going to be transformative for human medicine. Just think about it, yeah? We are all used to the concept of small molecule drugs, which need to be dosed daily. Right now, we are talking about using the molecules, which you can administer once a year, or maybe every 6 months. So to some degree, we are talking about transformation of the human medicine from pumping pills towards a vaccination.
The promise of gene therapy to finally have a treatment for genetic diseases has become a reality. The South Coast facility has a dedicated set of instruments and manufacturing suites that are completely designed for the manufacture of human gene therapy vectors. It's a tremendous time for us to be in this field of imaging therapy and to be able to bring these treatments to patients, to families who have these severe illnesses that were previously incurable.
MassBiologics offers a unique opportunity. I'm not actually aware of any other non-for-profit GMP manufacturing capabilities within academic institutions that enable translation of breakthrough discoveries towards patients. When you are going towards clinical translations and patients, things need to be done perfectly, and I think MassBiologics is fantastic.
Nothing makes an organization like this, part of the medical school, more proud than having contributed to the well-being of the public health and individuals.